Gotta wear
That's
your coat.
It. That's it. Did you say there was a 5 stages?
Yeah.
5 stage coats.
Yep. Yeah. Four stages. And that fifth one. Well, there is no fifth one, because that fourth one, you don't go out.
Look, you just stay inside.
So this level, coat level we're talking about will be for today, I would say maybe 3.
Yeah. Yeah.
Maybe 3.
For right now, yeah.
Until it warms up. It's supposed to get nice today. Mm-hmm. Maybe in the upper 30s, lower 40s,
yeah, about like
or
34.
So. Yeah, okay. Yeah. I can take that. No more snow.
No snow, as long as it ain't no snow.
Just don't snow.
At all.
Omaha, Nebraska. Welcome to the broadcast. Welcome to the Boss Morning Show, yes. Here at 95.7 The Boss.
The Boss.
Let me know how y'all doing out there. Our Facebook Live viewers. Good morning. Come on into the live stream. Yes, we appreciate
good morning, good morning.
How's everybody doing?
Before we start off and just let everybody know that this weekend on the 20th in Lincoln, Nebraska, there will be a Care Bear for Kids Drive. There's going to be a lot of artists there. You can come on down. The event is only $5. You can bring a toy in place of the $5. It'll get you in. You know, more than one is appreciated. It's definitely not needed, but it will be at the is 340 Cornhusker Highway, Lincoln, Nebraska. So come on down. You know, go ahead and give. I know pockets are slim. You know, you're trying to get everything in for you and your family. You know, we want to spread mm-hmm. that love if we can.
Absolutely.
You know, a little bit further. So. Try to make it, try to come on out, try to go ahead and support, you know, and send
That's right.
a toy of your choice.
That is right. Omaha, Nebraska. We have a guest this morning.
Yes, yes.
We have Miss Keisha Cole.
She not to be confused with Keisha and Nicole.
Right. You know, Keisha Cole, the eyebrow microblading specialist. That now, Keisha Cole.
Microblading, like, isn't that where they take a razor?
It's
brow.
It's I'm not sure on the specifics. I know it's a form of tattooing the brow, so you don't have to ladies don't have to do their brows in the morning, which that would be totally cool with me. I don't, you know. So
we gonna wait till she gets
down, but we're gonna let her break it down.
Right, a tattoo to the eye to the face is kinda.
So that's all nervous. I know about it, and I know her work. Look, it turns out very beautiful. So I'll be down for that. So. We're going to have her in the station here live at 95.7, the Boss during the Boss Morning Show. So you guys stay tuned. 7:30, she is coming up.
Yes, and we also have another person stopping by.
Mm-hmm.
Spencer Williams, the Indigo Kid. He's going to come in because it is, Love Thyself Thursday? Is that what it is?
Mm-hmm. On Thursday, yep. Today yes.
Is it Thursday?
Today's Tuesday.
Today's Tuesday?
Yeah.
Look now, honey, I don't know what's going on. I don't know what they is.
Tell the truth Tuesday.
Tell the truth Tuesday. Well, we can equate that to this as well. He's going to come and talk about a couple of the chakras, you know, the meaning of them, what you can do to raise your levels, you know, about your melanin, your carbon, you know, real quick. And just give us a little lesson on that real
all
quick.
Right. All right,
yeah. Just giving us some information to carry through our day.
Okay. Wonderful. We sure appreciate our guests from yesterday coming Definitely. In, giving us some wellness tips and some self-love strategies so that we can
and
carry
a rub
out.
Down.
Yeah, yeah. You were like, oh my God, you were into it.
I was.
Massage that Charles gave you?
Yeah, because he like stretched out my muscles. He didn't like really massage. He really stretched
kind
them out.
Kind of just stretched them.
Yeah.
Okay.
And it really made a difference.
Mm-hmm. And I learned that technique too from, I learned of the technique from going to massages, getting massages at Universal School of Massage. And the lady, the masseuse, she told me that if you, for sciatica nerves issues, a lot of people deal with that, you stretch out that muscle because what happens, it kind of curls up in a way, and that's what causes the pain.
Yeah, that's exactly what it felt like. I'm not even gonna lie to you guys. Like, the way he was stretching it, I was feeling it down my back. I was feeling it in my neck, my shoulders, my elbows.
That is, hey, well, you can test that then. I'm going to yes. check him out. Charles Ray
to.
Gresham.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure where did he say he was working out of right now? Was it the School of Massage?
Yes.
In the Florence area.
Yep, in the Florence area.
Okay, Universal School of Massage. That's where I go. I haven't been there in a while, but I need to. In 2020, I'm going to do better.
Yeah, make sure you go see them. I know they have their event coming up. It's a week-long thing. and like they attend and get your body and your minds right.
That's right. They're going to have a self-love bingo on December 29th over at the AIM Institute, 1905 yeah. Harney.
Mm-hmm.
So that's from 5 to 8. So sisters, if y'all ready for another round of self-love bingo, come on out. Come on out.
Yes.
Omaha, Nebraska. How's everyone doing? We appreciate you, listeners. We also appreciate you as well out there listening from your radios. You may be at home. You may be listening from your car. You may be listening from work. Maybe you're already at work.
Right.
Take us with you everywhere you go. That's right. Download that TuneIn app. You know what I'm talking about. TuneIn mm-hmm. radio app. Search 957 The Boss.
The Boss.
And you'll be able to get us nice and clear.
I want to say good morning, Dewan Hall. Thank you for tuning in. Royalty AI, Artificial Intelligence. Hey, Tony Hunt. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Raymel, good morning. We are doing good. How you, baby? How you? That's the question. And Recall? I don't want to mispronounce it. You know what I'm saying? Up, honey, and said good morning. So good morning to you, babies.
All right, now.
I
think it's the lights.
What happened to our light lights?
Oh, yeah, you know, I need to bring back the lights because, yeah, we are kind of dark. I'm darker, and like behind this mic, and I'm wearing dark. I'm trying to like just all black.
He's at all black everything.
King, how you doing this morning?
I'm doing good. Blessing to be alive. It says, tell the truth. Tuesday.
That's right.
So everybody's kind of in slow motion. Let me turn my mic on first. They probably didn't hear nothing. I said, how's everybody doing this beautiful morning? It's a beautiful day to be alive.
Yes.
I think we're gonna have some vitamin D today. I encourage you guys to get your vitamin D on with iodine. Shouts out to those that support the station. 2020 is coming up. We're gonna be intentional. In every move,
yes.
Johnny Rogers say it is game day every day, and so I'm going to perceive the world from that standpoint every morning. So I'm doing great. Mm-hmm. How y'all doing?
Good, good, doing all great. Right. Just want to shout out to our friend here in the radio land. He's family because his career has been in the radio. We want to say goodbye to him as he moves on into retirement. Yes, I'm talking about Tom Joyner.
Yes.
He is calling it quits after the legendary 25-year career in radio due to salary cuts.
Oh,
great. Entertain and empower the African-American community. That's what we do here mm-hmm. at 95.7 The Boss. For decades, legendary radio host Tom Joyner is signing off for good. The Tom Joyner Morning Show. Hey, I love that show. Mm-hmm. Aired for the very last time last Friday morning.
Oh, wow.
The show first aired in 1994. Let me give you a little history about him if you don't know Tom Joyner. And he went on to become the number one syndicated urban morning show in the country, reaching more than 105 markets and nearly 8 million listeners nationwide. In an interview with CBS This Morning, the 70-year-old radio giant admitted that he decided to retire because the radio industry doesn't pay as much as it used to. At his peak, Joyner said he was earning an annual salary, get this, of $14 million annually.
Mm.
However, that figure has been slashed several times in recent years.
Lord.
Joyner began his broadcasting career in Alabama immediately after graduating from college and worked at a number of radio stations in the South and Midwest. Starting in 1985, he began simultaneously hosting a morning show in Dallas and an afternoon show in Chicago for 8 years, earning the nickname The Fly Jock, you might remember that.
Yes, yes.
And the hardest working man in radio. Yes,
I
shout out
that.
To you, Tom Joyner. Go ahead and live your life.
Look, okay.
Going into that retirement life.
Okay.
I know that's right. You earned it. Go ahead and enjoy.
Now.
I had an opportunity to see him speak in person at a conference in Washington, D.C. You know, I go up there and lobby, you know what I mean? That's where all the laws are made.
Right.
You
for
know,
radio?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Broadcasting?
Right now,
okay.
You know, and I had a chance to meet with him and dialogue. He's been in the business for a while. So I soaked up a lot of knowledge. Shouts out to Brother Joyner. Brother Joyner, we
nice.
Got a job here for you at the boss.
Come on, man.
Oh, man. How can you retire on live, Brother Joyner?
He said he's calling it quits.
Okay, it's over now.
It's over now.
It's look now, that's the top Jordan cruise.
That ain't no joke. I'm gonna go on one of them cruises. All right, we love you over here, Tom Jordan. Enjoy your retirement.
Yes, definitely.
Omaha, Nebraska. What time is it?
Hey. It's 7:11, honey.
Oh, and our guest is here, bright and early. Hey, Keisha Cole.
She got her partner with.
How you doing, sir? All right, we're fine. We're gonna boss. What are we gonna do? We're gonna play a track, or
we're gonna play some music, and then we'll get our guests all set up. What is today?
Today is
Tuesday, the 17th. It's the countdown, y'all. It's the countdown to the new year. And we're bringing in businesses every day to stimulate your mind, but also let you know expertise that comes from our community. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Today is Tell the Truth Tuesday. You got to tell the truth.
Got to tell today. The truth.
I don't need no Bible to tell the truth. Oh, no. When my mama blew my butt, I had to tell the truth. There's no Bible around. It's just me, my mama, and the belt.
Okay.
You should have told the truth before the belt.
That was the
belt. I was trying.
No, you wasn't quick enough.
I wasn't quick enough.
That's all right. Omaha, Nebraska, 7:13 now. We're going to go to a track. Make sure you stay tuned. We're going to have our guests coming up here soon after our break. Yes. We appreciate you. We appreciate our school bus drivers out there. We see you. We appreciate you toting around our special, precious cargo. That's right. Our babies. And shout out to our daycare providers. We know that you're with our babies all day long. We appreciate the work that you do in your while they're in your care. Woo! Make sure you stay with us. It's 7:14 a.m.
Found me in a place where I can shout all my troubles over. God, you've really been good to me. Everything I've been through, you've been good to me.
Yeah.
way. I don't know the way. Nobody can do it like you, Jesus. No, no, no. He made a way. He been good. He really been good. Yes, you have. So many times, Lord, you made a way for me. You're really, 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 really. He made a way. Out of no way. He turned my darkness into day. So many times, I wanted to give up. Nobody could do it.
That said, oh yeah. If y'all didn't know that, you know, put this go out to the grown folks there. Yeah, you gotta be over Miles Davis. No, it's not Miles Davis. This is he's a jazz artist. Oh yeah. Yeah. I told you. Yeah, you gotta be a certain. Is it Robert Washington?
Yes. I think it's Grover Washington. Washington Jr.
Yes, it's Grover Washington.
But
there we go.
Mr. Magic.
So we're going to just a little Grover Washington in the background.
Y'all like that? Early in the morning.
You got to like that.
And you know that plays for like 9 minutes. You know, back in the day, we used to have the 12 inches. See, these kids don't know about 12 inches. You know, no, you get on the floor, you dance for a while. Oh, yeah, especially with the slow song. Brothers, I know y'all remember those 12 inches. Oh, yeah. Projects. You know what I mean? Oh, yeah, without a doubt. Oh, yeah, the music played for like 10, 12 minutes. Oh, yeah. The one song. Shouts out to our brothers and our sister. We got a special guest in the house. She has talent. Oh, yeah. I think she said that she made people look good. Yeah, I like looking good. You know, I like looking
for
good.
For real. I do it for real, for real.
Hey, we grooving. I am like enjoying this. Hey.
So, you want to introduce our guest, Martine?
Oh, sure. Absolutely. Omaha, Nebraska. We're bossing with Keisha Cole. She is the eyebrow and microblading specialist. If you don't know what microblading is, she's going to break it down. We welcome you to the Boss Morning Show, Keisha. How you doing?
I am good. Thank you for having me on the show.
You are welcome. You're the first of our guests to be rocking to some jazz in the background.
I feel privileged.
All right. So you're going to set it off. We don't know where this is going to go after this. So welcome, welcome, welcome. So let us know a little bit about your background and how'd you work up to the interest of opening up this type of business?
So as far as my background goes, I have been doing microblading for about 6.5 years now. And how I got into it is my best friend. She has zero eyebrows whatsoever. And she went and got the service done. And I seen how her brows looked afterwards. She went from literally having nothing to having full-grown eyebrows. And they look natural. They look real. And I saw how much it increased her self-confidence, her self-esteem, and how it really brought her face out. A lot of people don't really understand just how brows can make or break your face.
Yeah, okay.
So after she got it done, I was just so blown away by the whole process and just the before and after. And I was like, I got to learn how to do this. I have got to learn how to do this. I'm like, this is art. I'm an artist. I grew up just drawing. Like, literally, I can look at something. It doesn't matter what it is. And I can draw the intricacies, the details of whatever it was that I was drawing. So I was like, this is art. And I can help that I love doing the most. And I was like, I got to learn how to do this. So I went to Chicago, got trained. Learn how to do it, and initially I started doing it at home, and then I started doing it at salon, and then I worked my way up to having my own business doing it, and it's been a life-changing experience, and I've been able to start my own business by doing microblading.
Well, Like, can you explain to us, like, exactly the process? Because y'all know I don't do needles and blades. Microblading seems like somebody about to slide across your jaw with a whole hot blade, you know? But I know that's not what it is. So let me not scare y'all.
I think she's already done Look, that.
But can you explain the process and, like, is it painful? Like, what's involved? Give us a little bit more insight on that.
Okay, so there's two types of microblading that we do. One of them is called just regular microblading plus shading, and the other one is called powder brows. So the microblading, no matter which side of the fence you do, whether it's the microblading plus shading or the powder brows, we use numbing. So it's
that's a good thing.
A lot of people don't know that. So as far if you're scared of pain, I say don't worry about it as far as that goes. So what it is initially we'll do a consultation. We'll go over what your needs are for your brows, your desires. Do you want it to look natural? Do you want to see the lines? Do you want to is longevity, is that your goal? Did you lose your brows due to cancer? Did you lose your brows due to age? Did you just tired of drawing your brows on every day?
So that makes a difference. Mm-hmm. What they lost them for?
Yeah, and look at the skin also. So that depends on what your goals are for your brows. Depends on either if we do the microblading plus the shading or the powder brows. The difference between the two is the microblading plus the shading. That's where we will draw little teeny tiny fine lines in the brows. It mimics the natural growth pattern of the brows. So we put color inside your skin. Oh, so okay. It ends up giving you a just more fuller, natural looking eyebrow. Gotcha. And the powder brow, that one's done with the tattoo machine. Don't let that scare you, though. I know she's already scared you all. Don't let that scare you. So it's done with the tattoo machine, but we don't go as deep in the skin, and we use numbing, so it doesn't hurt as much. Okay. But with that one, there's no lines at all. It's a completely filled in eyebrow, just like how you would powder your eyebrows in if you did it on a regular basis with your eyebrow pencil or your eyebrow makeup. And that one lasts up to 2 years.
Oh, okay.
So the other one, you usually do on average, most people is like a yearly maintenance to it. But initially what we do a consultation, and after the consultation, we'll draw your brows on and we'll go back and forth as far as shape and thickness and color and things like that. Once we've agreed to a shape for your eyebrows and thickness for your eyebrows, then you'll get numbed. So don't worry. I'm looking at her face. You'll get numbed, and the numbing, it doesn't require any needles. It doesn't require any pain, but
about that life,
it doesn't really scare me. I mean, people get tattoos, you know, all over their body. Yeah. So, and I know this is our face, but it doesn't really scare me. If you have the numbing, it's probably not as bad as like a tooth pull or something like that.
It's not even. It's not even as nowhere near as bad as a 2 foot.
And you're certified for all this.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Because I've seen something. Have you? What's the worst you've seen somebody come in? Like, can you fix this?
The worst that I've seen, I would have to say two things. I've had someone come in and their eyebrows literally was what their normal eyebrow shape is that they liked for themselves. Is it literally looked like a mountain? Oh. So that's what they wanted me to do. Just the mountain. So, and they wanted me to microblade that on their face. I'm like, I can't put my name on that. So I had to turn her away. And I think the other thing that, as far as the worst that I've ever seen, this wasn't actually with me, but this was in Kansas City. Some people have seen this because it made national news. There was a lady that had her brows done, and she had them done by somebody that wasn't licensed. And so they didn't know what they were doing. So if you do decide to get microblading done, you want to make sure that the person who's doing it is licensed. Mm-hmm. So the person wasn't licensed. They didn't know what they were doing. They gave her eyebrows. It looked horrible. And then she took it upon herself to go to somewhere else to have them fix it. And they ended up giving her literally 4 eyebrows.
How?
Yeah, she literally she had 4 eyebrows.
My mama said, it don't make sense. Don't try to make sense of it. So I'm not going to ask.
So she had to go through a whole process of getting both of those eyebrows removed and then getting the service done again. So,
wow.
Yeah.
So do you have a lot of people coming to you for microblading or eyebrow?
Oh, yeah.
Arching or whatever?
Oh, yeah. We have a lot of people because the service that we do, it benefits people who are cancer survivors. Because a lot of people who are cancer survivors, they've lost a lot of their brows. Some people's brows don't grow back. Some people's do, but it doesn't grow back fully. Mm-hmm. And then you have us as we age, things go downhill. So a lot of us will lose some of our brows. So we're able to fill in those areas that you lost so you can have your thicker, fuller brow back that you used to have. And then you have the women who draw their brows on every day.
Oh, that's me.
Every day.
She's pointing at me.
Do you have yours filled in?
No.
You don't?
I just brush them to the side.
Oh,
I
go.
I literally draw my brows. I have half a brow. So the tail is, I'm losing brow on the tail end.
Near the end?
Yes. And I don't know if it's just... I don't think it's really been a full brow all my life, even. So I do draw my brow on every day or finish, you know, fill it in. Yeah. And I would like to come and get that service because that daily brow drawing of a brow, I'm tired of it.
Yeah.
Man, I might come in and get this one fixed. I'm lopsided, y'all.
And one brow turns out different than the other brow. I'm getting better, but it's still, to me, it doesn't look the same.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, you know, coming in for services like that where I don't have to retouch it until months or even years, sometimes, depending on which service you get.
2 years.
Yeah, two mm-hmm. years. That sounds amazing to me. So let us know. Oh, you do have an academy where you teach people how to become certified microbladers. Is that what they're called? Or?
Yes. Microblading artists.
Microblading artists. Can you just share a little bit about that process? And maybe there's someone listening that is interested in getting into the field.
Okay. So what I can say about our industry, it's an amazing industry. And the reason why it's an amazing industry is because it's life-changing to not only the person that you're doing the service for, but also to you yourself. So the person that you're going to be doing the service on, the number one thing that a lot of people get from getting the service done is self-confidence. Mm. Their confidence increases, their self-esteem increases. And for most people that are daily drawing their eyebrows on every day, it saves them time. It saves them money in the products that they have to do. So that's a reason why a lot of people decide to get the service done. So, but on the flip side, for the person that's actually getting the training, the certification, the microblading artist, mm-hmm. it's very rewarding financially for us because it's a high dollar service. Mm-hmm. So that means you work less and you make more money. It's a high dollar mm-hmm. service and it's also high, it's in demand. It's high demand.
Oh, really?
So yeah, so it's a trade, it's a skill you can keep with you for the rest of your life. And mm-hmm. the training itself is only for 3 days.
Oh, really?
Three-day training?
It's a 3-day training. And it's, like I said, it's an investment in yourself. It's a skill that you can make money on within a short period of time and for the rest of your life. So a lot of people who get trained are usually people that are into beauty. They either they're into beauty, they do their brows on a regular basis, they do makeup, they do other people's makeup. Anyone who wants to side hustle, anyone who wants to get out of the current career path that they're in. I came from the medical background and I switched 100% over to being a microblading artist.
Might be a microblader.
What's your medical background?
Medical background. Mm-hmm. I used to work with the Department of Veterans Affairs. So I was over a lot of the medical assistants at the Department of Veterans Affairs.
Okay.
So that's what I used to do. And I had decided that I wanted to work for myself, that I just was tired.
Tired of the 9-to-5 grind.
Exactly. I'm a very hard worker. I'm not a lazy person, but I was like, if I'm going to work this hard, I'm going to work for myself. So
that's right.
So
you talked about it being high demand. So what markets or what cities is this popular in, microblading?
Pretty much all cities, unless it's a small rural town, pretty much everywhere, because women everywhere draw their brows on, women everywhere age and lose their brows, women everywhere have their cancer survivors, thyroid mm-hmm. patients that lose their brows. So it's popular like everywhere, unless it's a small town.
Now more than ever, it just seems like a lot of women are more in tune to, like, you know, beauty. We got mm-hmm. a whole lot going on mm-hmm. when it comes to beauty. Sometimes mm-hmm. you have, like, you gotta get up 2-3 hours early to get up. I just seen it happen, hey. Trust me. It ain't me. What?
And the beauty industry. The beauty industry is $1 billion, not really more is. Industry. So.
If I'm not mistaken, it's the number one industry right now, mm-hmm. at least in the U.S.
Beauty.
Mm-hmm. Now, do you have a lot of people coming to you like for corrections? And like, how do you do a correction on a microbladed brow?
Yeah, we do have people that come in for corrections, and it's really a case by case type of thing. So it just really depends on what's going on with their brows. Mm-hmm. Like, did the person make their brows too thick? They don't like the shape. Did the person go too like deep in their skin and like they've damaged their skin? Did the person use cheap quality pigments on them and their eyebrows are red? So it really is case by case. Some cases we take, some we're able to do color corrections on. Some people they have to do removal for the microblading that they had done. So it just really all depends.
Oh, you can like remove it. Like,
mm-hmm.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Yep. But the class, it's a 3-day class. It's a 3-day class. Yeah, it's a 3-day class. It's a Saturday, Sunday, Monday class. We teach you literally everything that you need to know to get into the industry from A to Z, not only doing the services, but we teach you marketing. We teach you advertising. We give you after support after class for the for the rest of your life. It's a really good class. And a lot of people who have taken the training, they've moved out of their career that they're currently in, or they've started a side hustle, or they started a side business. Me myself, like I said, I went from a 9-to-5 government job. People thought I was crazy when I quit. They're like, you're leaving a government job with government benefits? Yes.
Said,
and I haven't ever looked back.
Now, where are the classes held?
We have two locations in Omaha, Nebraska. We're located in the Benson District, and in Dallas, which is downtown Dallas, Texas.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Do we have an address for the Benson District?
5723 Northwest Radial Highway in Omaha, of course.
All right.
It's on the corner of 57th and Radial Highway.
Okay.
Right across from the Bucky's gas station if you're a local.
Oh, okay. Look.
Nice. So, Keisha, let us know your journey as an entrepreneur. You talked about you were working in the medical field at one time, and then you decided you were ready to move on to making money on your own terms. What was that like as you to kind of take that, you know, that leap of faith and leave your 9-to-5 to pursue your passion in this industry?
One thing I can say was scary. It was scary. It was a lot of ups and downs because it was my first business and I didn't know anyone in my family and my friends, anyone that had done business before. So there was a lot of learning that I had to do, a lot of learning curves. But I can definitely say I've learned a lot, and that's why I can pass on what I've learned to my students and to anyone that wants to start a business. There's a lot of knowledge and wisdom that I have that I'm able to pass on to everyone else. But as far as the journey goes, it's been hard, but it's been good at the same time.
Yeah, probably very rewarding.
Yeah, very, very rewarding.
And you mentioned you were the first in your family to become an entrepreneur business owner. Did you have any background? Did you take any business classes or anything?
No, I did a lot of research. That's what I did. I did a lot. I just knew what I wanted. I didn't know how to go about doing it because I didn't know, like I said, I didn't know anyone who had done business prior to myself. I didn't have any relationships with anyone that had done business before. So I was just like green, didn't know anything. I did a lot of research, and that's the main thing was research. Lots and lots of research.
Can you break that down for your industry? What type of research did you do?
Because
that's important for people that are launching out in their own business to do the analysis, the research up front in your industry to make sure it's something that people will want, make sure it's something that you could make money in.
Yeah. So initially what I would say as far as research, I didn't do too much research on my industry at the beginning because I didn't know that you have to do research, which is very important.
Yeah, that's a lot of reason why people don't do it because they don't know they have to.
Exactly. Right? But now it's like if you want to go into business at all, you have to do research.
Tell them.
You have to know your competitors. You have to know who you're going to be catering to. You have to know if the location, if you need to go online, if you need to do local, and you know, because you need to, that's a part of your success.
Definitely.
But initially, I didn't do any research as far as my specific industry goes. The only thing that I knew, because I learned it from school, I took a marketing class while I was in school, is if there's a need and there's people that can pay for that need, then you have a business.
For the need, yeah.
That's all I knew. That's all I knew. And I'm like, oh, there's a need, definitely. So I was like, and people would definitely pay for this. So then I have a business. That's all I knew.
See, I'm glad that you're the type of person to really just, you know, take what you didn't know and the things that you didn't know and, you know, give it to someone else and give them, you know, the courage and just the tools to like do something like that for themselves. Like, that's important nowadays.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
oh,
it's
yeah.
not a lot of people doing those type oh, yeah. of things, just feeling they just want to, you know, philanthropically. Like, you're trying to give people a way to start their lives in a whole different way and give them the tools. That's a beautiful oh, yeah. thing, people. Yeah. That's yeah. a beautiful thing.
Yes, I definitely know the pathway of what it takes and what you need to do in order to be successful in this industry. And I can pass that on to my students.
That's beautiful.
And other people that are in business, because a lot of the pathway to success when it comes to having a business is pretty much the same, no matter what your industry is.
Now, as far as your classes, like, is there a price that, you know, is there a fee, is, you know, like, and give us like a ballpark of, you know, where it's at. Or do okay. you offer other services besides microblading
oh, yeah.
classes?
Yeah, we also have a spa and a studio. So we don't just do only the microblading training. We do the service too. So we do microblading, we do the powder brows, we do henna brows, we do brow lamination, we do facials. Okay. So we're going to be getting into doing lashes because that's really big right now. So it's other things also besides the school part. We have the studio and we have the spa. But you said the price for the class, there's two different classes. We have the microblading plus shading class, which is a 3-day class. That one's $3,000. And then we have the powder brow class. That one is $2,300.
All right.
Is it possible that students can get financial aid?
No, unfortunately, in our industry, that's not something that we don't do financial aid in our industry. So we use a lot of PayPal financing. So a lot of people will use either the PayPal financing to finance the whole entire class or a portion of the class. It's based off of the credit.
Meaning that PayPal will extend them credit if they are approved.
Yes.
To pay yes. for their classes. And then yes. they just pay them back.
Yep. And which is good because PayPal, they have 6 months 6 months interest free. So mm-hmm. if you can pay it off within the first 6 months, then you don't have any interest at all. Another thing that some people will do is they'll just do like a down payment and do like weekly, bi-weekly payments. And then once they're paid up, they'll take the class then.
Well, that's good that you guys are offering that as well. Just, you know, as like a stepping stone to sometimes you can't, you know, sometimes our pockets ain't that big.
Yeah,
you know,
I understand.
Like, okay, I want to do it. It's good that you provide, you know, ways mm-hmm. that they still can, you know, get to the class and not have to, you know, just drop the whole wallet right in and right there if they ain't got it. So,
exactly.
Like, shouts out to you, Ma.
Yeah. And I always tell people to count the cost because some people are like, oh my God, $3,000. How much is that? But like I said, it's a high demand yeah. service. And it's also on average in Omaha, it ranges anywhere from $450 up to $700 to have the service done.
Okay.
So even though it's $3,000, that's an investment and you can make that back within, depending on the person, you can make it back in a few months. But remember, it's a service that you're going to be able to provide for the rest of your life to make money for yourself, for your family and everything like that.
Right. Okay. Now, you said that it's permanent. So are you a tattoo artist at the same time?
We are tattoo artists specifically for the face.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, where can people find you to get their brows done?
So I will give you our phone number. It is 402-215-1722. 402-215-1722. You can also check us on any social media at Eyebrow Microblading Specialist. Make sure you put that S at the end, otherwise you won't find us. And the website is eyebrowmicrobladingspecialist.com.
Hey. Your fans are rolling in. Sabrina Taylor. Good morning, Sabrina. She says,
hey, Sabrina.
There's my girl. Now, do you find that working in the, I know you've gone to Dallas and you've kind of spread your wings. You're in the Omaha market already. That's where you started, right? Mm-hmm. And now you've expanded to Dallas. Is there any dreams of going into other markets for your business?
Oh yeah, most definitely. Next year, New York City, and then internationally.
Wow.
Yeah, international is either going to be sometime near the end of next year or the year after.
Mm-hmm. Is there a a request for this service internationally? Is it already popular?
Yes, it is.
What markets do you mind saying internationally where?
Mexico. I also want to take it to Africa. I've talked to a couple people that are from Ghana and from Nigeria also, and they're like, oh, yes, the women would love this. Mm-hmm. They would love this. So,
oh, my gosh.
I'm going to take it to Africa, also to Puerto Rico. Those are some of the locations that I have on my mind.
Mm-hmm. Currently, what ethnicity is or what culture is doing this? Is the Far East, because you know they kind of monopolize, you know, the hair that black women buy, the nails that's done, that black women always spend
in
money
China?
With. So this remnant.
I said it.
Okay.
Right.
What'd you say? What'd you say? Can you repeat that?
In China.
So this derived from traditions of China, as far as how the women.
Yeah, it originated in China.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
In Asia, in that region.
Okay. Cool. Now, are you the first black to do this? Because
in Omaha, I am. Like all in Nebraska, I am. First black, no. I'm not.
Because I never heard this before. And then also, what made you decide to open up? Because you have a school, is that correct?
Yes.
Oh, what made you decide to take it to that level? Because most people just get into it and just work. But you decided to get in, work, but also teach others.
I decided to do the academy because I love helping people. And also, I come from an education background. I have family. A lot of my family members are educators. I used to teach in the church. So education is naturally in me. It's a part of me.
Mm-hmm.
So, but the main reason as to why I chose the education side is because I like to help people.
Okay.
And I know what it can do for people once they get this trade and to do the service.
Now, you said a trade could be done in 72 hours? Three days?
Yes, in 3 days.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So
it's a three-day training.
Now, what's their potential revenue if from a side hustle to a full hustle? What's the potential revenue for a person with that small investment? Because to me, $2,300 to $3,000 investment itself is really small, because we spend that in crazy stuff every day. Entertainment, chips, pop. And,
entertainment. Yeah,
yeah, it is small. It is small. And what I can say is that there's people that's in our industry that's making $10,000 a month just doing the service.
Wow.
So it's really dependent on the person, on their drive.
Say it one more time.
There's people in the industry that's making $10,000 a month doing the service.
Okay.
So
and what area of the country? Because, you know, the population base is different here. I'm seeing that you're going to take your skill set, you know, to other areas, especially to New York, where there's 15 million people.
Look now, you know, I'm familiar with the East Coast, baby. Don't have me traveling up there to tattoo.
Yeah, there's people in Omaha that's making that also.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Okay.
But that dollar amount is more so in like New York, in California, in Texas, but we can make it here in Omaha also.
Okay.
It really depends on the person's drive.
Okay.
And if you know, people can do they can count the cost for themselves. Like I said, it's $450 to $700 on average to have their service done. The $700 range is more so like the dermatology, the plastic surgeon's office. People who are independent are more so like $450 if they work in a salon, if they work in a spa. That's more of their price range, $450 to
$600. Okay. Oh, that's not bad. And you said that most of this, it lasts for like 2 years, right?
Depending on what service you get. The regular microblading plus shading, which is just the lines, that one on average, they'll come back in about a year. With the powder brow, with that one where it's completely filled in with color, that one is up to 2 years.
See, that's beautiful. Like you, that's longevity on your dollar, honey.
Also, I got a quick question. I just been reading research, and my sister experienced this with dye in her hair and her eyes swelling. Now, there's been a link to dye in black women hair, especially in relationship to cancer. Breast cancer.
Mm-hmm.
So
I read that the other day.
Is does tattooing, especially, I mean, I know we've been tattooing ourselves for centuries. Mm-hmm. So do you think that's a correlation by putting ink in one? I got a tattoo one right here, but it hurt like crazy. So
did you cry?
Tell the truth. Yeah, and I really don't like needles anyway. I know I want to get another tattoo, but I don't like that pain. I really don't like that pain. Are you concerned with a correlation like that?
So what I can say when it comes to cancer, so our industry has been around in the United States for about 30 years now. Mm-hmm. We don't have any statistics or anything like that that says that it causes cancer. But at the end of the day, it is a chemical that you're putting into your skin. So who knows what the long-term effects might be, because that is a chemical that you're putting into your skin. Right. Just like the lotions and potions and soaps and stuff, all of that stuff is chemical. So everything could potentially be harmful to you that you do.
Right. Most people don't know the largest organ in our body is the skin. Mm-hmm. Yep. And so I'm ashy. So if I take my clothes off, I'm ashy. Oh, yeah. Would I die? Because I'm not going to be putting on lotions. And most of it has been tested by pigs and other primates. That's how they test the lotions.
What about oils?
And oils. Well, I use natural oil. Oh, yeah. I go to the African American bookstore. Shout out to and then I go to Martin. Oh yeah, to get our
shea
get our,
butter.
Yeah.
That's right. Shout out
shea butter.
S&M African Boutique.
I go to get our shea butter, which is cut naturally from the tree. It's from Africa. And so if I don't apply something to my skin, I try to make sure it's natural, because our largest organ is our skin. And so, without a doubt. And so I do got one tattoo and it's still there. But some people say that some tattoos have some, some health qualities. I don't know. Mm-hmm. But we've been doing it for centuries.
Yeah, we have. And there's always a possibility that something that you put in your skin can potentially harm you if it's not 100% natural.
Right. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Now, you've been moving around Dallas. You're going to go into New York. Have you built a team or is it just you?
We have a team.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So explain to me how you came to that that space where you needed to grow your business, because you're wanting to do more things. And I know as a person running a business by themselves, it's hard to grow if you don't build a team, and just mm-hmm. kind of let people know, entrepreneurs know that that's important when you want to grow and maybe move into other markets.
Yeah, definitely. You can't grow and keep your growth without having a team. It's impossible because you're only one person. There's only but so much time in a day, mm-hmm. and there's so much that needs to be done. There might be 50 things that need to be done and you're only one person. You can only get but so much done. So you're going to fall off somewhere. Mm-hmm. I have a bookkeeper. I have an assistant. I have him. You all can't see him. I have my guy. Definitely if you're trying to grow your business, when you initially start, if it's just you, that's okay. But eventually, if your goal longevity, which everyone who's in business should be to grow your business, mm-hmm. You definitely need people around you, and you need good people around you, mm-hmm. not just anyone.
And even like with social media and marketing, some business owners, hire someone to do their social media marketing, because I know that's huge, mm-hmm. a huge way to market and let people know about what you do. Are you on social media anywhere with your business, and do you have like videos and things like that?
Yes, on Instagram, on Facebook. I think those are only two that we're on, because that's the main two that mm-hmm. we need for our business.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good. Omaha, Nebraska, we have been bossing with Keisha Cole.
And Nicole's been better say it right.
Founder of Eyebrow and Microblading Specialist. She has a business here in Omaha and Dallas, which is a place that I love. And yes. She's going to be expanding her market in different areas, New York and internationally. You guys look her up if you're interested in getting her services. Look her up, and I'm going to have her shout out her contact information again. Also, if you're interested in becoming a microblading eyebrow specialist, she offers classes. She has an academy, so you can contact her about getting started. 3-day training, which is not bad.
Not at all.
You're investing in yourself, pay the money, learn the trade, and make that money back in 2-3 months. And then some. I mean, it's a lucrative business. She's already said that. A great way to, take that leap of faith and start your own business, mm-hmm. side hustle, whatever you want to do. It's your business, so you can do with it what you want. Mm-hmm. So Keisha, again, let us know your contact information.
Okay, so phone number is 402-215-1722. Website is eyebrowmicrobladingspecialist.com. Make sure you put that S at the end. And Facebook and Instagram handle is eyebrowmicrobladingspecialist.
And Sabrina says, I'm on her team.
pal. Yes, you are, Sabrina. So she's on the team. Sabrina's been there from the beginning.
Right. Absolutely. Shout out to Sabrina. We need those kind of people in our lives as business owners. Teresa Jackson says, hey, Keisha, I love eyebrows. Good morning, Martine. Hey, Teresa. Thanks for watching the Boss Morning Show. We appreciate you. Any other last words, co-host? What you have of Keisha?
William Dorch, he think he in the wrong field. He said, he said 10 G's a month. I'm in the wrong business. Well, now get your hustle on.
I'm trying to tell you, this is just added on as another side hustle.
We got William. A million.
That's what I'm talking about. I don't think I'm artsy. Do you have to have experience?
No, you don't. We teach you literally everything that you need from A to Z.
Okay. Yeah,
that's not something you have to worry about.
I know that's right.
Wow.
And for my people out there, I went ahead and shared all her information where you can contact her, the classes and everything in the comments. So go and check them. We will be posting them again.
Oh, yeah. I'm proud of you, sister, especially opening up an academy to teach others. Mm-hmm. So what you're doing is what the work of Jesus did. He taught people how to fish. And so we appreciate you. You are necessary. Her name is actually Keisha Coles.
Yes, it is.
I'm the original. I'm the real one.
Right.
So her name is actually Keisha Coles. I said, man, why are they calling it Keisha Coles? Because of the hair? Is it the style?
That's her government.
Her name is actually Keisha Coles, y'all. Omaha.
I do autographs too.
Do you Metro get that a lot? She gives autographs. I better recognize.
You got your own show and everything.
Right. You legit. We thank you for being on the Boss Morning Show.
Definitely.
And we, you know, you got your sidekick, your partner. He's on the team too. Hey, how you doing, sir?
Hey, teammate.
So we thank you for coming in and sharing your morning with us, educating our community about what you do. Keisha Cole, with founder of Eyebrow and Microblading Specialist. She has a business in the Benson area. If you want to walk in and get some services done, some lashes, she's got it for you. She's certified and all that jazz, so you don't have to worry about that. She is legitimate. She's been trained. You went to Chicago to get your training, certified, all the nine yards. So she is good to go, you guys. So if this is something you're interested in, see her. And then if you want to do this and make some good money, like Dorch said, he's like, I'm switching professions too. I'm going to add it on as a side hustle. You think I can add on amongst everything else I do, Keisha? Because that's pretty good.
Superwoman Martine, you can do anything.
All right, then. Well, we thank you for coming in again. We appreciate you. We're going to take a break, right, King?
Yep, here we go.
And we're going to return back. I think we had someone else come in.
Mr. William Spencer, the Indigo Kid.
All right, so we got our second guest up. Omaha, Nebraska. It is now 7:55. Boss with us. Thank you.
head of the shell TNT. Let's fade on the keys.
Rise. We the people that hustle. We the people that struggle. We the people that fight for it. We the people that work. We the people that hurt. We the people that live. We the people survive. We the people that stand up. We the people that try. We the people that give. We the people that hope. We the people that want peace, but we the people that know. Ain't no peace when police killing in these streets. Ain't no love, but it ain't no drug that's gonna change how it be. And at night I hear the shooting, cause it wake me out my sleep. Damn, another brother died cause of crooked police. We the people gotta speak, gotta rise up out to sea. Don't nobody really care, a brother die about a week. More killing from your brothers than the police. COP 12 one time and Blue Street. Supposed to protect the peace, but you act like our enemy. Run up on us with your pistols and put us down on our knees, then you search us, don't find nothing, and still don't want us to leave. You start shooting like it's a movie, we figure it's OV. We the people that rise, we the people that hustle, we the people that struggle, we the people that fight for it, we the people that work, we the people that hurt, we the people that live, we the people survive, we the people that stand up, we the people that try, we the people that give. We the people that progress. We the people that want peace, but we the people that know.
We the people they call savages, recreating our images as primitive. With slavery days made it definitive, based on race, what a disgrace. Man, that's ridiculous, it still ain't changing. It's sad to say, we gotta live through this. Living under tyranny, under guise of democracy, where people have a voice to people living in poverty. Our hoods are still the same, where it's nothing but broken poverty. And jobs don't pay enough. More money comes from a robbery. Solution is to put us in prison, never to listen. Not understanding the issue, problems nobody fixing. They try and hold us down, and still my brothers uplifted, cause they blind to our struggle, but we got vision.
T-Bone. We the people that rise. We the people that hustle. We the people that struggle. We the people that fight for it. We the people that work. We the people that hurt. We the people that live. We the people survive. We the people that stand up. We the people that try. We the people that give. We the people that hope. We the people that want peace, but we the people that know.
Oh yeah. Omaha metro area, we are the people, without a doubt. Y'all listen to the Boss Morning Show. Oh yeah, we want to thank God once again for bringing us live. We want to thank our guest, our last guest. You know, she started a school. You know what I mean? That's an actual love thy neighbor move. When you can teach other people how to fish, oh yeah, man. That's the world work of Jesus. I remember my homie, oh yeah, my man Mitch. Oh yeah, when at his funeral, oh yeah, he had thousands of kids. Oh yeah. Because he did it for real, y'all. We the people. Yeah, oh, yeah. It don't stop. I want it all. You should want it all also. Everything. Oh, yeah. Tell them no good. It's from Omaha. This is how we do it, baby.
I mean everything. The houses, the cars, the hottest bars, the fortune, it all. A sense to belong. A crown and the throne. The king going dumb. Just try to put the kingdom on. There's only one thing that I know. Well, there's a tune if ever I am. Now I'm ready to go. I want it all. This petty game, man, it might go. Change my lanes in this petty game, man, I might blow.
Residual, De Niro,
I might get a little more. Hope I can run with the Taliban, like the menace claim. Around shackle through my way to get more. And I was thinking recognition, instead of going on missions and ripping the frame out of everything I know existed. I'm the only one deserving to get his ass kissed. When I live with individuals who lyrically live everything that they know is done, just to take care of their children, who sit across the rooms and listen to their parents to go try to stop for a living, wishing they could give them riches. Daughter, lifestyle of rich and famous, where Robin Leach is, but I ain't tripping, cause it's gonna happen, cause I just spoken into existence, and you the witness, listen, now who laughing? I want it all, I mean everything, the houses, the cars, the hottest bars, the fortune, the fame, I want it all, a life full of hope, from the lines that I wrote, through the pursuit of happiness, man, I want it all, a sense to belong, a crown in the throne, the king going dumb, just try to put the kingdom on. There's only one thing that I know. Well, there's a tune if ever I came and I'm ready to go. I want it all.
Send the situation's critical. Step on the gas, watch out fast life come at you full blown. On my honor, the drama so intense you feel it though. And I heard it's my turn to feed the world with momentum. Had an alternatum to take the nation by storm. By any form, I decided to come back and just hit them like an umbilical. I can watch the weak that burn them like 10-4. In any form, I decided to just roll with the spiritual. We got the monopoly, we don't pass go, pass go. I know youngsters who pop and go with 44s. And they ain't even reached 14 years old. No, for life is rolling around on rackets, strolling on death row. It's the part of the game the books don't teach us, though. But they said we could be taught, though. But if I remember correctly, the oldest anatomy of humanity scholars we found was even in minus wrong. Yeah, I want it all, that mean everything. The houses, the cars, the highest bar, the fortune and fame. I want it all, a life full of hope from the lines that I wrote. Root on the pursuit of happiness, man. I want it all, a sense to belong, a crown in the throne. The king going dumb, just try to put me even wrong. There's only one thing that I know, well, it's a 20-foot game and I'm ready to go. I want it all, that mean everything. The houses, the cars, the highest bar, the fortune and fame. I want it all, a life full of hope from the lines that I wrote. You know the pursuit of happiness, man. I want it all, a sense to belong, a crown in the throne, the king going dumb, just try to put the kingdom on. There's only one thing that I know, well, there's a 20 if ever I came and I'm ready to go. I want it all.
Oh yeah, if you listen to 95.7, oh, you are a very important person. Job today with your head up, your shoulder back, cause you VIP, baby. Oh yeah. Yeah, you listen to the boss, you know RV. This is your theme song. Shaft got his stuff. Oh yeah, VIP baby.
I show no ID, you know why? Cause I'm VIP. I got a pocket full of green, and you know what this means? That means that I'm VIP. They show nothing but love when I'm up in the club. Why? Cause I'm VIP. You wanna hang with me? You wanna hang with me? Why? Cause I'm VIP, I'm VIP. Hey, when I step in the club, they already know who's the best in the world. From the east to the west, all the rest of the clubs. When I come through, they show love and throw it up. I'm in the back, in the back, and I'm bottle for the jack, and I'm out full of kiss, I got that sass in the club. Pocket full of green, man, I'm fresh and so clean. I'm so fresh as a whale, I'm fresh in the club. Yeah. Hey, I'm a party on. Yeah, I'm a party on. Mommy got Bacardi line, she said it's party time. Damn, that Bacardi gone. Ain't killing my vibe, ain't killing my high. Yeah, I'm in my party zone. I got my drink and my two-step, my drink and my two-step. I'm a party to the party gone. And tell us, I show no ID. You know why? Cause I'm VIP. I got a pocket full of green, and you know what this means? That means that I'm VIP. They show nothing but love when I'm up in the club. Why? Cause I'm VIP. You wanna hang with me? You wanna hang with me? Why? Cause I'm VIP. I'm VIP.
I'm on cloud nine, up in the club, but I'm feeling fine. Never a nickel, baby, always a dime. At like 5-1, I get better with time. On the dance floor, feeling fancy free. I represent my team, the 313. Yeah, we VIP. Dressed to impress, as you can clearly see. But this is crazy, though. Yeah, this is crazy, though. I'm the chick in the click.
I'm the chick in the click.
Yeah, with that crazy flow. You need to stop all the hating.
Stop all the hating.
Yeah, you can save it, yo. You wanna roll with me? Meet me in VIP. Yeah, that's Lady Rocky. That's me.
Yeah. I show no ID. You know why? Cause I'm VIP. I got a pocket full of green, and you know what this means? That means that I'm VIP. They show nothing but love when I'm up in the club. Why? Cause I'm VIP. You wanna hang with me? You wanna hang with me? Why? Cause I'm VIP. I'm VIP.
VIP, why body and your boy Ree. Came in on 10 and it's all on me. I could've did the long sleeve or the 2C. At the bar, buy it out like it's all on me. VIP, walk in. Feeling all tipsy. It ain't no problem for the night because my dog with me. 10 on me right now, counting all 50. 745 back to back with the 550. I'm playing rounds in the parking lot on 4G Autos. Dang on my wrist like a gold bottle. I walk in the club looking like I hit the lotto. Low key, mixed breeze, sipping on the sky. I make a rain, make a flood, make the weather change. Tear the whole club up like a hurricane. VIP, spend it all, buying everything. Running through a whole 12 like a shoestring.
I show no ID, you know why? Because I'm VIP. I got a pocket full of green, and you know what this means? That means that I'm VIP. They show nothing but love when I'm up in the club. Why? Cause I'm VIP. You wanna hang with me? You wanna hang with me? Why? Cause I'm VIP. I'm VIP.
Oh yeah, Omaha, Nebraska. I told you guys are VIP. Yeah, you know that last sister that came in here. You know she teaching people how to fish. You know, making people look good, y'all. So we're gonna have to step it up, y'all. We got a people named Indigo coming here with the king crown. Oh yeah, oh yeah, I like that. I didn't tell him my last name.
Indigo.
Yeah, Stacey. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Everybody know that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you know,
Indigo know about
promote locals all the time. That's what it's about.
Yes.
We're independent, man. Just all locals.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
I know. Okay. I follow your show. I follow your show.
Why don't you go ahead and tell them about your show? Hold on. You know how these stars are, y'all. You know how these stars are. I'm going to give them the right intro because,
I like it.
I mean, the man coming in here with a king crown. I want to mimic the young brother. I want to copy off of him. After he leaves, I'm going to have me a crown like the brother. All year. That's how we should feel every day. Because, you know, tell the truth Tuesday, he is a king.
Yes.
All year. Every day. All day. You know, they said that we are the reflection of God, right? Oh, yeah. Straight up. Right down. We made in his image. I tell everybody that every day. So we made in his image. Why we have his mentality as well? We have to start understanding. I like this young man. I ain't gonna challenge him at all. Yeah, he already spit knowledge because we are the direct image of God himself. You know, I know I'm a God because I bring things from the abstract to the concrete
every single time. Thank you.
You know, didn't God do that? I'm a child of God. The radio station was an idea. It was in the abstract and it had no form. Oh yeah.
Then I manifest.
Oh yeah. And then I took a step every day. Yeah, I took a step every day. Then God took a step every two steps.
He was that loyal.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I was dedicated.
I love it.
Medicated. Oh yeah. With the seed of hope. Oh yeah. They call that mustard seed, the smallest seed.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
The
spirit of mustard seed. Oh yeah. I'm the preacher. I'm scared all the other preachers away. I'm the new preacher of Omaha, y'all. I'm claiming it.
But that's what I teach everybody, you know, even my friend Indigo Key, we're all spiritual healers or teachers in some kind of way.
Okay.
You know, we have to start, most of us like to heal people in a certain way with being sympathetic. But most of us have the knowledge and information when we become teachers. Or they call it motivational speakers these days.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we have to go out there and start preaching what you know. But you can't take it to the grave.
Heck it up, what I thought. Now, you old folks, he just said it. Can't take it to the grave with you, my elder. You got all that knowledge. Reach back to the young folk. Oh, yeah. Pull one back and teach. Now, this brother, you know how these stars are. You know how these stars are. They got their own adjectives, noun, verb, prepositional phrases, all yes, and predicates. We're going to let him introduce himself because he's looking good. He's looking good. He's looking good. You know? And so I'm going to let him introduce himself. And it's my first time actually meeting. I went back in the room and all I know, we had Indigo come. You know, I know what Indigo mean. Does it glow and mystify or something?
Now.
Yeah, it's a lot of things for the most part, but it's about the third eye. You know, man, that's the third eye chakra, and it represents intuition, creativity, and imagination. You know, it's pretty much what we out here expressing it each and every day. We got to keep dreaming. We got to learn how to get back to that childlike state where we're always dreaming. Like everybody worn down now by stress. Everything that's going on in life, in society, and their own individual problems. We got to start dreaming again so we can start to manifest what we truly want.
Brother, introduce yourself. It's like you know about the gas station.
So I know about all the locals here.
I know you how you use a mic.
Yeah.
And so use that diaphragm. We want everybody to hear you.
Okay.
The gas station to slide off in the next 5-10 seconds, and then we're going to let you have the total floor. But, you know, he did a lot.
Yes.
He knew it was a gas station. Mm. It was a gas station. So let the people know who you are, what's your God-given talent. I don't know who brought you on the show.
It's Queen right here.
Yeah, so
I appreciate her.
That's what I'm talking about. Queen, King, Queen. I like that. I like to talk this morning. Talk the truth Tuesday. So tell the truth, big brother.
My name is Spencer Williams. It's my government name, what I always tell people. But I like going by Indigo. You know, that's the person that who I've become through all the experience that I've come in life. But I come by way of Roanoke, Alabama. I've been in Omaha, Nebraska for like 3.5-4 years. I actually like the people here, the energy. I was brought up here by a good friend. And for the most part, I love expressing myself. You can find me on Facebook, all the Instagrams and the social media sites at Indigo Kid. But Spencer Williams is my name that people know me by. But I appreciate this economy. I got a business degree, accounting as well. But at the same time, it's all about healing the people, you know, knowing where we're going in life.
Now, you said Alabama, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, what part of Alabama again?
Oh, Roanoke. It's like right above Auburn.
Okay, spell that, bro.
R-O-A-N-O-K-E. Yeah.
Okay.
What major city is that by?
Roanoke? Auburn, Alabama.
Okay.
Another big city. I still don't know what that is.
It's about an hour and a half from Montgomery, Alabama.
There we go. Yeah, okay, you know Montgomery. Okay.
Okay.
But for the most part, I did get my education in Montgomery, Alabama, speaking of that. So shout out Huntington College.
Hey.
I really appreciate the information that I got there. And everything is always an experience. You know, even how I got here, just from meeting somebody at that school who brought me up here. So I really appreciate the process and what's going on and how I got to be where I'm at right now. Even right now, it feels a little surreal because I've been behind the camera. I do filming, you know, and everything. But to actually be with other spirits, we share the same energy, you know, all the time. So knowledge is everything.
Now, you like a young man. Lucky young man.
I'm 32.
Okay.
So you know what I mean.
Okay. All right. Cool. Now, what got you into your realm? So you got a business degree from what college again?
Huntington College. Huntington. It's a 4-year private Methodist school in Montgomery, Alabama.
Okay. I went to a Lutheran school.
Okay.
Okay. Cool.
I went there to play football to be exact. My boy say Midland.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
I'm not going to say
Midland University. Do your thing.
Yeah,
I'm
not going to say nothing.
I give all shouts out to alumni. I appreciate people who can further their education. College is a marathon, not a sprint.
Right.
You know, it took me 8 years to get a 4-year degree. I'm proud of it, to be honest, because I learned more than just business.
That's right.
Where a lot of my knowledge comes from. Everything outside of business. It's crazy.
Nice.
Okay. Now, how did you get to Omaha? What's your migration?
I played football with a guy named Dale Franklin, and he moved up here for a female, of course. Mm-hmm. It just didn't work out the way he wanted to, but I stayed. You know, he brought me up here to get with a job. I was doing commercial housing and staging, but I was always a bartender and server at a place out west called Firebird's Wood Fire Grill.
Okay,
I know,
hotel.
It's one in Montgomery, Alabama, too. So that's the one that I came from. But so I just bought that job with me. Two jobs, a great economy. I know how good this economy really is. And with my business degree, I can micromanage and macromanage a lot of things around here. Most Fortune 500 companies, most billionaires per square capita, you know, lowest unemployment rate, things that Alabama just doesn't see.
Right.
You know, and I can definitely relate. That's why I stayed. Uh-huh. So for the most part, since I've been here, I started my own clothing line, Indigo Kid, Conscious Streetwear for the Enlightened. That's who taught me how to do a lot of this stuff. My friend Dale, who bought me up here, he's like, you need to be a walking billboard, man. Like, let people know who you are. You know, you need to express yourself.
Right.
And, you know, the definition will come later in life. So the vision statement is always clear. I want to enlighten the people. You know, I chose the logo of the rainbow because of the chakra colors. People don't understand what the rainbow truly means. And that's what I'm really trying to bring out to them. You know, I bought my guide here. But for the most part.
So the rainbow is not about
what they
think. Yeah, sexuality. It's not about sexuality.
Oh, man.
Okay.
It's been here long before that.
Now the sun's coming in. Also, God is coming.
Yeah, bro. And I'm on that kind of. That's the kind of energy I'm on too. I felt it shining on me, and I was like, man. He's like, do your thing now. And for the most part, 7 days of the week. Like,
okay.
People.
Okay.
Who,
I've been bringing.
Okay, now what's a chakra now?
Okay, I'm glad you asked. Chakras are like tops of invisible spinning energy, and they resonate to different energy frequencies.
Okay.
So our bodies not matter. It's all energy and wavelengths. Mm-hmm. Atoms, they right. tell us this all the time.
Right.
But they move at different frequencies. That's why it's always important to be in a good mood at all times. You know, that way you can transfer good energy. You can't destroy or create energy. Energy needs to be transferred.
Right.
So when you transfer in good energy, it's always going to be good. But we got 7 major centers on our primary body. They act like doorways, you know, to the spiritual realm that we need to be getting into.
Okay.
The people of our descent have always known this and of higher knowledge.
Okay. Now, this is not a religion, is it?
Nah.
Okay.
It's all spiritual because everybody has their own chakra system.
Okay.
That's why people, we have the right, the freedom to do what we want to do, but everybody choose not to do what's integrity. You know what I mean? People know right from wrong.
Yeah, without doubt.
But once you start living that life, you know, eating the right things, always exercising, because you have to exercise this. You have to write this this body needs to be worked out in mm-hmm. all forms and facets.
Right.
To talk with, to speak spiritually, we need to meditate as well. We need to make sure we're staying humble. Like all kind of characteristics that go along with it.
Right.
But when it comes to the chakras of the 7 days, like yesterday just started, like the people who empower know this for the most part. That's why the work week begins on Monday.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
You know, making money Monday.
Yeah. You know what I mean? But and after you felt holy on the Sunday,
right,
with the Saturday, you know,
right.
And but as you go, as you progress, you know, Monday is the survival day. Today, which is Tuesday, it's all about being sensuality, sexuality, being around partners. You know what I'm saying? And manifesting together. Two brains is always better than one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, when people start becoming in groups and tribes, for the most part, they started thinking alike. That's when the belly chakra was born, because people had the same ideologies.
Mm-hmm.
Tomorrow's mostly all energy, because it's going to be the navel chakra day. And then Thursday's the heart chakra. Friday's mm-hmm. the throat chakra. Saturday, which is indigo, the third eye chakra, which is located. And all these have anatomy terms, too. You know, the anatomy term for the third eye chakra is the pineal gland. People know it as the third eye, you mm-hmm. know, and that's where all our knowledge lies from. That's also another meaning behind me wanting to do indigo, you know.
Okay, is that the first is that the frontal lobe or what lobe is that?
No, it's actually right in the center of the brain,
right in the center of the brain.
Pineal gland, p-i-n-e-a-l gland.
So that gland's actually protected then?
Oh yeah, it's super protected.
Okay now let's go to the first chakra,
the root chakra. Survival instincts, primal instincts, which was yesterday. In the work world, not in the, like, cause we pretty much had got places to live, you know. Back in the day, that's all they was mainly focused on, was hunter gathering, finding shelter for the most part, learning things. That's all base chakra stuff. But we live in that now for the most part. We have a place to live. We got a job to go to. We know how to make money. You know, the problem we have is with the heart. Once we can unconditionally love, we can then begin to experience the spiritual chakras of the throat, the third eye, and the crown.
So where are we at in the process?
As far as the evolutionary process, society?
Yeah, far
probably in the energy phase, the navel chakra. We're experiencing a lot of energy coming in all sorts of fashions when it comes to technology. It's definitely exceeding itself. The birth rate is exceeding the death rate, which is very nice too. That's a lot of energy coming into the world. People don't understand what the sexual energy means as well. Back in the day, they didn't want to just have intercourse like we do for fun these days. They wanted mm-hmm. to bring about new life so they could manifest it as well with the energy that we already know about. So
mm-hmm.
it's real hard. It's real deep. We can get to the heart chakra right now, but it's going to be kind of hard for everybody to love unconditionally.
Right.
Without wanting something back, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Right,
which
right.
is living that day and time.
But isn't Christmas for that?
Pagan holiday. If you only knew how much money Christmas brought in, you know. I mean, it's a good time to be in your family. I agree with that concept.
Right.
I've only been home like 4 times since I've been up here.
Mm-hmm.
It's like 18 hours to drive back and forth. Man, I can't do that all the time.
Well, I mean, they got pretty cheap flights now. You go to Memphis.
Yeah, I got a dog though too, so I don't like you know.
You leave the dog.
My dog has never really traveled like on a plane yet. So if I take myself, I pretty much take my dog too.
Okay.
You're right. Christmas is the time for that loving though.
Right.
As a matter of fact, speak on that. Everybody needs to get back to the loving. Don't give nobody gift this year. Give them the conversation that they need to hear.
Mm, yeah, but
I forgive you.
Yeah, without doubt. And we talk about that, you know, consistently. Ladies, you got any questions for Brother Indigo?
I love questions.
Actually,
and before you start, can I get the sun out your eye? Is that bothering you?
I'm actually good. That's that energy we were talking about.
Okay, I was going to say, I may want to ask that.
I'm still manifesting right now.
So you okay?
Yes, son.
Okay. I want to ask you about, because I know you have a show that you do, mm-hmm. And I know you have your clothing line that goes along with it. Like, what is, you know, some of the things that people can expect from your show and the information that, you know, you think that is important to, you know, people of all color? You know what I mean?
For the most part, it's getting back to loving yourself. It's hard for us to give the love to other people because we don't love ourselves.
Right.
Literally, internally, mm-hmm. we have to love ourselves. It's actually a form of indoctrination. You know, that's why I tell everybody I'm not from Alabama. We all from our mothers. Let's just mm-hmm. get that straight. We just raised by different indoctrination systems. Mine just happened to be Alabama, you know. Education is really low, you know, obesity rates up. It's so many things wrong, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Politicians, we can get all into that. It's a whole nother story. But, you know, when I come up here and like, I see these other economy's thriving in such a way, I'm like, why can't everyone have this? You know, but once again, it's systematic. But mm-hmm. once you have the information and you apply the information, it becomes knowledge. And once you get the knowledge and you apply the knowledge, it becomes wisdom. So we just got to keep learning. We got to keep mm-hmm. teaching. We can't be afraid to give out information. It's just information, mm-hmm. you know, or content. Yeah. That's what they call it. It's called content mm-hmm. in the mainstream world. That's why they put their name at the bottom of everything.
And see, I mm-hmm. like that. That's why, you know, I try to catch your shows when I can, because there's always something that you bring that I didn't know that I take and I try to hold throughout my right. day, you know what I mean? And try to keep in remembrance, you know, of what you said so I can, you know, like, I know yesterday was what, the root chakra?
The root chakra,
correct. You know, and I did go ahead and say that.
You did mention that.
I've been trying to bring y'all the chakra, you know, from him every day.
Absolutely.
It was, you know, the color was red. And what is today's chakra?
Today's chakra is the sacral chakra. Like the I sacral. Was bringing up, if you turn this over right here with the sensuality and the sexuality.
Okay, now where is that located?
It's going to be below the navel. So okay. you find the navel is probably about 2 centimeters. I've mm-hmm. actually looked at all these chakras too, and I actually do the vibration to raise the frequency every morning with the and you can actually feel it going through your body too. But this takes deep meditation. Everybody mm-hmm. just can't block everything out of their right. mind. Mm-hmm. That's why meditation is so hard. You got to block mm-hmm. everything out. You can't watch no TV. You got to be in a certain space, a certain area, mm-hmm. and be able to shut everything down, like all your senses down, except for the mind. Because some people, they're afraid to be alone with their own thoughts.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's why they got so much stuff going on, the TV, the
telephone. Gotta have the TV going in the background.
Everything gotta be mm-hmm. going on. Like it's really crazy. But to be honest, meditation has saved me a lot. You know, and now I'm getting better and better information. I'm starting to apply the information. That's why a lot more knowledge is coming out of me now, and I feel better about it.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Let me ask you a question. For those that are, because yesterday we talked about gypsies.
Oh, yeah.
Mystifiers and
the voodoo and all that
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, yeah. So because we got one of my brothers up to high school where he says spell chakra. So
in the,
you know,
in the English language is chakra.
Mm-hmm.
It's pronounced like chakra. But, you know, everybody says it in so many different ways. You know, right. it's chakra. You know what I mean? Uh-huh. That's how you spell say the name. Everything is it's vibratory. You know, everything okay. is frequency and wavelengths. That's very funny. That's a good question, though.
I was going to ask that.
Spell it one more time.
Chakras.
Now, what did this derive from?
Hindu and Sanskrit.
Okay. Now, that's where I thought.
I'm sorry. I go through this on my show as well. Chakras. They're like tops of invisible spinning energy, and they resonate to the different energy frequencies. And these frequencies can be felt throughout the physical body through different types of emotions, sensations, as well as thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And chakras derives from Sanskrit and Hindu as wheel of energy. Mm-hmm. And there are 7 of these wheels of energy that are located on our primary centers, like I was telling you earlier, that are considered like doorways. You know, we got them on the front side and the back side of our bodies. And they close up sometimes when we're not doing what we're supposed to be doing in that area. You know, because we feel the stresses that weigh on our body.
So and it's
you
like
know,
a vortex.
Yeah, they're mm-hmm. like vortices, correct.
Okay. Now, if one master itself, what's the ultimate?
It's called Kundalini, and that is what the goal is. I was talking about this a while ago. Lachey, if you will read that right there for me, it says the goal.
All right, it says, the goal is to keep the chakras open and balanced with energies that are positive and correct the negative energy effects that can block the harmonious flow of life force energy.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, so since energy cannot be destroyed.
Correct. Or created. That's all I thought in school. And it's so
what
funny.
Class? What class?
It was a science class. Okay. I want to say like a physical education or something.
Yeah, I figured, but mm-hmm. I know energy can't be destroyed or created.
It's like Newton's laws.
So yeah. it's a constant.
But everything's about science, though. Mm-hmm. The reason right. I got to the spirit realm is because, you know, I'm raised Southern Baptist.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But religion, it's so many of them. It's the reason that they're doing it, too. It's all about mm-hmm. the division on the beat, you know. Mm-hmm. Religion is never really supposed to have been about anything. It's a tool to control the mind. But true spirituality comes from within, and can't nobody take it from you once you have found it. That's right. Why it's so important to get in tune with yourself and be who you need to be. Science, which is what rules the world for the most part, is seen spirituality. We know this because of the periodic table. Everything that's on the periodic table is made up of something in this room,
some element
in this world, correct? But spirituality is unseen science.
Right. And I do believe in invisibility. So I understand that there's molecules or atoms,
correct,
that we can't see because
we're made of, correct,
because they're moving too fast, like air.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah.
Or oxygen. We can't see it, but we know it exists. Mm-hmm. We know it exists because we can feel it. We can tell it in the temperature.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Same thing with the chakra level. Mm-hmm. We can feel when our body's aching at certain parts. Mm-hmm. You know, and every day I teach people just to try to do something. Why, like, for instance, on a Friday, which is the throat chakra day, just speak everything into existence, all the good stuff that you want to do.
Okay, so I like this. I like this.
I know that, you know, when it comes to the chakras, there are colors that are, you know, equated to each of the chakras. Now, are there certain like foods that you should eat that day, like colors you should wear?
Of course.
Things that you should be meditating on for them.
Of course. And to go to the fact of the foods, that's why we need to be more on a plant-based diet too. Everything of color comes from nature, like carrots, apple, like when they're good. But of course, it's kind of hard these days because they, Monsanto and everything, that they own our food supply.
Yeah.
That's why it's very, very important to really grow your own foods. Mm-hmm. But we need these things every day to fuel us. And it needs, we're herbivores, let's just put it that way. I've been saying this, like, we develop these canines. We don't really supposed to be eating meat, but we're supposed to be eating the nuts, the berries, and the leaves. Like we're supposed to.
Okay.
Like that's what keeps us strong and keeps us revitalized.
Would that sustain our life if we go by that diet, or would we still die?
No, we won't die because we'll be given the necessity of proteins and amino acids like we're supposed to through all these foods because they're plant-based. These are God-like foods. And I put these foods on my show for a reason. I don't put meats. Like today, I put papayas and mandarins. I'm going back to the show too, so whoever watching this is
okay. So you brought him because he does the show.
Every single morning. It's called Chakras, The Road to Indigo.
And what time are you on?
Normally around the time of 9 to 10, but I keep it going for like 45 minutes. And it's normally 10 minutes of the show of me doing my chakras with the lesson of the day, the food of the day, and stuff like that. But at the end of the show, I take about 10, 20 minutes to just shout out the people who have supported me and the people who I support. That's why I know so many people in the community, because I've been around and I've been out, you know, through the entertainment world. I used to help run the record label WTF Record with my man Eclipse. So for the most part, I've gotten out here. I know these people. I've networked with them. I now got my own filming company. The own clothing line is running pretty rapidly right now. A lot of my friends back home are buying it. So I really do appreciate that. But I like to show love. You know, I give three principles every day: paperwork, investment, and group economics. You know, if you go out there and get the LLC, nobody can steal these intellectual thoughts. You know, this is what God gave us. So you put it in paper, which is what they want us to do, so nobody can steal your stuff. Like, then you begin to monetize it. But you got to invest in yourself. You know, we spend so much of our own money, we're not putting our money right back into the paperwork that we just got so we can begin to see profits, gain generational wealth. That is the key word, group economics, which is the very last one. You know, you got to go out there and show some love to people.
Absolutely.
You know, you have to support somebody else without expecting anything else back. Because that's the way it works. You got to give it away for free for a little bit until you get so valuable, it ain't going to be free no more. You know, that's the key. Like, I have a lot of episodes pretty much to still put out. You know, I'm just keep doing my show every day because I have to stay continuous. I got to stay consistent.
Your platform is what?
Facebook. Okay. Find me on Facebook.
And I've caught Indigo. I've caught your shows a couple of times.
I like it.
And we have some comments from Facebook Live viewers as well. Austin Bailey says, okay, I was right. I think he was the one that asked about how to spell chakra. Lena says, Lord have mercy. Yes. Ladarius Smith says, I'm into the chakras and meditation and the difference in energies and crystals. Ladarius also says, go ahead, young brother. You know, you have a lot of fans out there. So your show is weekly or daily?
Daily. Daily. Yes. Every day. That's what makes it consistent. You have to keep working. There's no such thing as retirement. Right. I feel like I can do this anywhere in the world until the day that I die, because I have a camera, I have a microphone, have something to say. I have content. And I have the platform.
Valuable content.
Yeah. Yes. You know, and that's what's happening right now. I'm just making myself more valuable. Mm-hmm. We have to become indispensable to people, because what we have a problem with is sharing information. Mm-hmm. It ain't so hard. Like, somebody else is good at something. You do videos really good. I need you. Mm-hmm. I'm not even going to try to learn videos. I'm just going to willing to pay you what you
need. Stay in your lane, right?
Yeah. And that's how you build teams. Mm-hmm. I learned about this thing called the DISC assessment. Dominance, influence, steadiness, and consciousness. It spells DISC. Mm-hmm. And this is how you learn through E.T. Eric Thomas, hip hop preacher. I love that man. That's my inspiration. But for the most part, you find out who you are as a person, because we all, that's why I love astrology. All this is based on sacred geometry, the science, everything's science. But people have dominant characteristics about them. People have influential characteristics. I think I'm more of an influencer, you know, but I do show signs of dominance as well. That's why I'm doing a lot of stuff by myself. Mm-hmm. Just look it up. A lot of people can look it up. It's called the DISC assessment, D-I-S-C. Yeah, and you get to really learn who you are based off your characteristics. There are no true or false answers. There's no yes or no answers. It's literally based off who you are as a person. So
now, you mentioned sacred geometry. Now, can you break down exactly what that is?
Of course, the Fibonacci sequence and the golden mean ratio. You know, the fact that one number equals the number that came before it once you add it. So you start with zero, then one, and then one, and then two, and then three, and five, eight, 13. You can look it up. This is like God's fingerprint. I've studied it so many times now. It's called the ancient secret of flower of life. And this guy got, yes, I actually own the book. It's by Drum Below Melchizedek. I've read like half of it, but I keep getting stumped because I need to digest some more of it, you know. Mm-hmm. But the Fibonacci sequence, the golden mean ratio, these things are known to the mathematicians of the world anyway, because numbers are infinite. That's what people don't understand for the most part. We have to start understanding what the numbers truly mean. That's what Nikola Tesla was on. And all these people who have all the technology world, people with Tesla, they know all these secret numbers, you know, but it just means something. I could go on for it, but I want people to really look up the golden mean ratio and the Fibonacci sequence. That ties into sacred geometry so much. Triangles, all about polygrams. And that's why math was such a strong point to me as well. I love geometry. I love algebra too when I was in high school. Like mathematics is what it is. That's why I went to school to try to be an accountant. But when I failed that class, I was like, I'm not waiting around for another year. I'm just going to go ahead and switch my major and go to business and do something that's generic, because you can always do stuff with a business degree. I was right. I got my own clothing line now. I got my own LLCs behind everything.
And can we get you to
that's where it starts at.
Show them your shirt.
Oh, yeah. Indigo. I like this one. It's black and gold. It's hard to see this one. But I got the Conscious Kings on the back. That's what it's really about.
Yes.
Yeah. All right.
And I like spelling it that way. But I got a lot of my stuff on Instagram. You can look me up, Indigo Kid 87. A lot of good logos on there. They're all designed by myself. I appreciate everything that people have done for me as well, because a lot of people gave me information about some of the logos that I should do as far as getting the categories down. But I like it.
Lena wanted to make sure that I read her comments. She says, hey, good morning. She says, tell the truth Tuesday. I like this young brother, Alabama. Break it down. Speaking the knowledge. Love it. Keep it 100.
That's another thing too, being in that geography lottery. You know, had I been born here in Omaha, who knows what kind of education I would have got. You know, it probably would have been good, but I wouldn't have known about the economy base of how things is, because Alabama's a red state. Nebraska's just a better red state. And now I can see that, and I can see why. Everything's a better quality, you know. I can even see the division still that I saw down in the south. It's called redlining. You know, I actually live on a red line right there on Northwest Radio. One side of the street is actually better than the other one. That's where they decided to divide things at. Yep. You know what I'm saying? People need to understand this. This is how economics work. That's why they're trying to buy back up some of this property down here in Omaha downtown. Okay. I'm like, trying to start it up again, huh?
So, Indico Kid, you do teach about energy, but do you also teach about economics and what you just stated with redlining?
I have not, for the most part. I just still keep looking into it. My business mind state won't go away, you know, mm-hmm. and the fact that I do everything in business and I pay my own business taxes, I have to be aware of these things.
I think it'd be good for your platform to kind of add that in the mix.
Okay.
As you know, you've got the platform, like you said, I got the mic, I can say what I want and talk and just kind of educate the community on that realm.
I appreciate that too, because mm-hmm. for the most part, that is what I'm doing right now too. I was falling in the trap of the debt like everyone is in, you know, but Dave Ramsey saving my life right now. I read that book and now I'm getting out of debt and I've changed my whole dynamics now. So that's the first thing. Like I said earlier, you can't help anybody else until you help yourself
first. That's right.
And, you know, I want to get my mom from stop working. She's still a CNA. My mom's 60 years old. She's still working. That's just that working class, man. You know, they never going to stop, you know, and I come from blue collar, like labor and stuff like that. But I know for a fact I can make it in the white collar world as well. Mm-hmm. It's just all about knowing the right people. Building it from the ground up, putting the work in.
And just learn more about entrepreneurship.
There's no white cavalry coming to save you. You know, student loans aren't going away. Mm-hmm. Credit card debts aren't going away. You can't bankrupt your way out of nothing. So money is pretty much what I'm learning right now. A lot of money is a tool. People need to understand that. Ain't nothing wrong with money. You just got to know how to use it. You got to literally get out of.
You better teach, brother.
You got to learn. just learn how to use it. You know, it's not hard. Mm-hmm. But I was one of those people, you know, I just didn't know, you know, ignorance is not dumb. It's just, you don't know.
Right. That's right. I'm glad you came on to talk about that and talk about the chakras. Like, I really appreciate it because there's so much that we don't know about ourselves internally. You know, we don't think about it because, you know, our day, like you said, our days are so busy and we got all this stress on us. So we don't think about a lot of the times, you know, what it takes to, you know, center yourself, you know, for you not to have those stresses. You just think, like, with the tool of money, I get more money, I won't stress as much.
Yeah, right.
That's not the way you go about it.
That's not the key.
You know, I'm glad you come on and I'm glad you have a platform you created a platform for yourself to go ahead and, you know, just give us that information about us internally and what we can do to, like, lessen our stresses and, you know, just be more insightful about self. Like, I appreciate you for that.
I agree. When you just start, the first thing is eating better. That's why they attack the food world so much. I literally have found that a certain type of intermittent fasting is very much so good. You know, eating like once a day, but eat a big meal, you know, eat it at midday, I've heard as well. They call it breakfast for a reason because you break the fast. Mm-hmm. Normally people don't eat dinner until like 6 or 7. You know, think about that 8 all the way to the other 8 and you're ready to eat again. It's almost 12 hours. But if you can just hold on to lunchtime, really, you know, just hold off a little bit. Your body can't digest that food while you're sleeping. It's just, that's a fact too. Yeah. People know that. You have to literally start monitoring your eating habits. And second of all, on food, I think we're eating too much. Mm-hmm. You know, three course meals every day is it's like a lot. You know, you want a snack between, you want a midnight snack, and it's just out of control. But
yeah,
definitely eating the right thing. That's why I promote fruits and vegetables for the most part. A lot of water. Like, I think the 8 cups of water is just pretty much a minimum. You know, we need to learn how to just drink all water sometimes. You know, I literally cut carbonation out of my life as well. Coffee's still one of those things I try to get away from. But in the morning time, I find it hard just to get up. But if you drink water right when you get up, it flushes everything through your body, I found. So I definitely got me some water that I call miracle water in the morning time.
Yes,
that I drink every day. Yes, the gemstones play a huge part.
And I saw that because I was just going to ask you about that. On his show, he drinks this water and it has like stones in the bottom.
Gemstones.
I know stones carry a lot of energy and water, it has memory. You know what I mean?
Yes.
You know, so I am not totally ignorant. A little bit something.
I agree.
But, you know, like, are there different gems that you put in the bottle? Do they come in the bottle? Like, where do you get the water?
And you can find some of these right here as well. They got stones down there. But the water can be any type of water. It's the fact of what you do to the water. And that's where that book comes in, that by Dr. Emoto, The Message from Water. Definitely go read this book, okay? It's telling you. 3/4 of your body is water. So about 90% of your body is water. 90% of the planet is water. Like, liquid is important. So for the most part is you pray to the water. That's all it is. It's a prayer, but it's also a manifestation of the prayer and what you want. Think about doing this every single day. I've been doing it every single day for about 5 months now. And I can actually see the progression that it's made in my life on a spiritual level. I really don't get as angry and stressful with people. I work in a serving alley, you know, a service, a restaurant. It's chaos every day. Mm. But I've learned to master my emotions a little bit better, you know, and that's really what it's about, learning how to maneuver in a room with people. Proximity Principle by Ken Coleman is another book that I'm reading that's allowed. I just got to be in the position around people in order to let them see you shine. Yeah. And then that's it.
Like, isn't it a fact that, you know, if you can change the way you behave when you're angry, it changes the chemical makeup of your brain. Yeah. If you can act
for sure
on something, because I know a lot of us go throughout our day and there's a lot of outside factors that, you know, keep us stressed, keep us, you know, on the edge. But if you can take whatever's bothering you and, you know, internalize it and turn it into something that's still just calming, calm yourself down. Mm-hmm. It changes the chemical makeup of your brain so that you're able to do those things more easily. And you, you know,
I think about how hard that is. You mad and you want to, you got to be good about being mad. About somebody that I'm playing.
Master the art of being angry.
So if you're mad, you can just put a smile on your face, say, shake your head.
You know,
so you're conditioning yourself to have a different mindset.
That's why it's so important to have a deep passion for whatever it is you want in life, because working for someone else the rest of your life is not it. Not manifesting what God gave you is like a sin, man. Like, literally, like, God's gift to you is your gift, but what you do with it is your gift back to Him. Mm-hmm. You know, we have to start understanding these things. We were given gifts. Some people are good at other things, but we need to start acknowledging that.
Right.
Absolutely. Really.
Sharing information, man.
That's right. Share the information. I teach on my platform, Indigo. Yeah, I don't know if you follow me or if you know, I teach about side hustles, how to start your own business, because this 9-to-5 thing doesn't work for everybody.
It does.
We've been conditioned from school to get good grades, graduate, and go to work for somebody. Get a job. But it doesn't work, especially for us, our kind of people. We move on. We're spiritual people. We move on rhythm. We move on beat. We can't be on time. We can't be on time all the time. How many times have you run and hit that clock? You supposed to be there 8:01, 8:02. It happens.
Just the way it is.
But it's because of our makeup of our people. As African American people, as Africans, you know, our ancestors were from that group of people. Mm-hmm. So I want to know if someone wants to get into the chakra and learn more about it, and they're like green behind the ear, like they know nothing. Mm-hmm. What's the first? Where could you send them to get, besides watching your show? Where could one begin the training, the learning of this, and get centered and understand the different elements that come with the chakra and the energies that come with that?
Okay. Well, I think it's mainly all about research. Everything in life's about research. The first thing is just look up chakras. Be primitive with it. Take it back to elementary school. That's how I learned things. I put it down on.
That's what King say.
I put it down on a note card. Like, what's the word? All right, the definition. I don't understand the definition. Make sure I understand the definition first, and then I proceed. Like, but from chakras, you're gonna find that there's only 7 major chakras. It tells you right here. These are the ones that we can control. That's why we got the heart chakra was born first. That's how we know we were born, right? With the heartbeat. Boom. Mm-hmm. But these lower ones are the physical chakra. This is what we can control physically. That's why I said once we break through unconditional love, we're going to be able to speak everything into existence the way we're supposed to, see everything into existence, because we use these 2 eyes to look and this one to see. That's why we have to really close our eyes to meditate to see the future. But at the same time, the crown chakra, which is straight subconscious, pure subconsciousness, you speaking directly to the Most High, whoever you choose to call him. That's the goal right there. That's Kundalini energy. And there are only 7 major chakras. We have over 122 chakras in this field. There's so many energy things that are around us that we can change just by changing the frequency of our own vibrations. Okay. Think about waking up every day to just no payments on everything. You can make money like how you choose to make money because of your craft. All your kids is taken care of. Think about how good you feel, like that peace of mind, that peace of body, physically, you know what I'm saying, mentally. Like all that stuff is like what they call heaven on earth, I guess, what you would think.
Now, Indigo, do you have a book? Or are you putting out a book sometime soon?
A book sounds prevalent.
I see a book in my future for you.
actually had a revelation about that the other day. I really thought about writing a book, and that's how people begin to get a lot of generational wealth. They write a book, mm-hmm. and all the royalties can go down to their families.
That's
and
right.
That's what it's about. Our parents and grandparents just didn't know about mutual funds and mm-hmm. insurance and stuff like this. It was okay, but I can be the one to change my family tree. So absolutely. I think a book definitely could be in the future. Let's get a little bit more weight under my show, a little few more supporters, maybe some investors, mm-hmm. sponsors, some other people who share the same vision, because you got to have a team first and definitely. Foremost. Mm-hmm. And I've been doing this thing by myself a little bit.
We were just talking about that with the previous guest, yes. having so a team.
Yeah, you got to have a team. I'm very convinced. And I know that everybody can't do everything, but once I get the team together, it's gonna be a wrap.
Definitely.
And we got about 10 minutes. Give the people your information again, how they can get in contact with you.
Of course. You can find me on YouTube. Just type in Spencer Williams Chakras, The Road to Indigo. Subscribe to the page, hit the bell notification. I got a lot more videos to come soon. You're going to find my Chakras Road to Indigo episodes, some promotional videos, commercial spots, because I do all that with my video image company called Indigo Images. So that's where I put my name behind with the videos. But you can check me out on Instagram at IndigoKid87. You can find me on Facebook. Just type in Spencer Williams / Indigo Kid. For real, if you want to follow me on Snapchat, if you want to, it's Cloud Status 2014. I got a lot of people who like support me on Snapchat. It's one of my major social sites. I like that one.
I like the King Crown that you're wearing.
Yes, Nino Brown 305. That's where I got this at. This thing is really not that expensive, but at the same time, it's like I said, it's the feeling. Once you start caring about what everybody thinks about you, everything falls in place.
I need one.
And so is it for sale on the website?
Oh, yeah, Nino Brown. Okay. WeTheBusiness.com. WeTheBusiness.com.
WeTheBusiness.com. Yes. Okay.
My boy Nino Brown, 305, stand up.
I be watching Nino Brown. He be talking smack.
Hey, he the ghetto preacher. Oh, yeah, they got ET, the hip hop preacher, but this my man Nino putting it in terms that
Nino Brown.
Everybody can just layman terms.
Yeah. I like Nino Brown.
How's that's Nino spelled?
N-I-N-O Brown.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Heck yeah,
I'm going to look him up.
Y'all have to.
Yeah. He walked around with a crown.
Oh, yeah. That's
where it got started.
We have to understand who we are, man.
That's
we
right.
I like that.
This is carbon-based. It's not melanin, too. I want to make sure everybody knows
we're carbon.
That this is carbon. We are made of things on the periodic table. Hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon.
Right.
And we, as the African-based spiritual people, have what they call ether 9. That's why our hair grows towards the sun. You have to understand these things. Ether 6 is on more so Caucasoid people whose hair grows down. The hidden colors as well. At the African American bookstore right here off 33rd Lake. Make sure y'all go in there and check them out. They got the information straight up and down. All right.
Then why did we say melanin?
It's a screening mechanism, like a smoke screen. They want to throw you off for the most part.
I think Francis Cress. Well, came up with that term in the book, the ISIS paper.
Oh, you've read that, brother? Mm-hmm. I got to get that.
The ISIS paper.
Oh, yeah. Dr. Browder got a good one, too.
Yeah.
Okay, but the ISIS paper, I got to have that one.
You dropping so much knowledge this morning.
Because I have it. Why would you not give it away?
That's
like
right.
I said, you can't take it to the grave.
But, hey, I like bragging, too. Hey, because I know I get my skills from God. So,
right?
Hey.
Nice.
So therefore, it's confidence.
Yeah, without a doubt.
That's right.
Don't get mad at me because I be manifesting my God.
Hey, tell him again, Mr.
Don't get mad at me because I manifest my God. I work hard for this. And I'm going to get my brown on. Yeah, I'm finna go outside for my 20
Look
minutes.
Now. Get all that information
I'm about to get
from
browner.
The sun.
Get that vitamin D. Soak up that
Tell
vitamin
them again,
D.
The sun powers all of this.
Yes.
Without a doubt. Omaha, Nebraska, brother. Give your information out again.
Oh, yeah. My name is Indigo. I like going by Indigo, Third Eye General. We are in the spirit realm here, 95.7 The Boss. Check me out on Instagram, though, at IndigoKid87. You can definitely look me up on YouTube, Spencer Williams, Chakras, the Road to Indigo. Make sure you subscribe to the page. All right.
Yeah.
Appreciate y'all.
All right. Thank you. Welcome to the Boss Morning Show. Thank you for being on the show.
I appreciate that.
All right. Indigo. Make sure you guys check out Indigo. He got some fans. Special William. That's his government name. So make sure you guys reach out to the brother. He has a wealth of knowledge. Man, I love bragging off our neighbors. We love bragging off our neighbors. And we have experts right here. Without a doubt, Omaha metro area. Oh yeah, make sure you guys, we got some tickets to get away. You know, 12 days of Christmas. Yes.
Oh yeah, 12 days of Christmas.
That 12 boss days till Christmas. We got 8 days to Christmas now. We're counting down. 8 days left.
Yeah, you know, I can't say all that English words.
All them English words.
That's not our language.
Yeah.
That's too funny.
Omaha got a couple tickets away to TJ Hooker Taylor. He's the son of the late Johnny Taylor. At a concert January the 4th, 2020. It's going to be at the Metro Community College. And you know, we are the soul. We are the blues. You know, I'm going to do y'all the blues today, but it's the good blues. Okay, without a doubt, we got two tickets here. You want to win them? Give us a call, 402. 763-6781.
Y'all getting the right number, G.
So whoever calls in first, you know, one of my board members gave me a couple of tugs of gifts, and I got to make them into a gift bag and stuff.
Okay.
So I got, two tugs and stuff. And so if you're a business person, you know, they can use it or whatever. Okay. Or if you're a startup, if you're trying to get your chakra on.
All right. I love it.
Kundalini on your chi. It's called prana energy in Japan. In Chinese, it's called chi. You know, we call it life
tai
force. Yes.
Okay.
So
all
right. Get you called, all right. Like, life force energy, though. That's what.
Hold on 1 second. Now, we got one of winners. You're a winner, right?
Yes, I am.
Let the people know who you are.
This is Brenda again.
Brenda, where are you calling in from, Brenda?
From my house.
Brenda. Oh, yeah. Do you got house shoes on right now, Brenda?
Yes, I do.
Lord have mercy.
She's a boss.
Yeah, yeah. You know, she's part of you. You get your house coat on and all that stuff,
she's
too.
She's a boss.
I have a house shirt on.
Oh, yeah, there we go.
It
sounds like my mama, you know. We love the mamas and the fathers that listen to us at home. I know y'all be chilling. Are you cooking grits this morning, Brenda? Because we hungry over here.
And you know what? The last time I called in and came on, I was bringing y'all breakfast, but had to go into work early.
I know you had to go today.
Yeah, I got to be there today.
Brenda, make sure you introduce yourself when we see you at this, because you won two tickets. We got it right here.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, you know, this is the 12 days of Christmas. You know, we try to get some love because family needs love.
Most definitely.
Music Fest. Blues and soul at the Metro.
Love it.
Oh yeah, we're gonna give you the blues that night. We're gonna give you the blues that night. Oh yeah, without a doubt, Brenda.
All right,
we appreciate you, Brenda. Well, we appreciate you. Why do now are you a mother, grandmother? What you do?
I'm just a mother of one.
Mother of one?
What's up, Rick?
Okay, shout out to all the mothers, without a doubt.
All the mothers, I agree.
Without a doubt. All the queens in the house. So you have my number? You know where we're located?
I sure do.
Okay.
I know everything.
Okay, good. All right.
Congratulations, Brenda.
She coming to get them tickets.
Now, for y'all that listen, do not insinuate that I know Miss Brenda in her house shoes, in her house coat.
Okay.
Congratulations, Miss Brenda.
All right, congratulations, Brenda.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Who are you bossing with? Let us know where you want the tickets from, Brenda.
Can you hear my co-host, Miss Brenda?
Miss Brenda gone. She said, I got the tickets. That's it.
She's with none.
That's over.
That's right. That's right.
Oh.
Boss. Overall, man, we appreciate you guys supporting the station with that. Be careful out there. Enjoy yourself today. Today is Tell the Truth Tuesday. Call somebody. Apologize, or receive a apology. You know, just tell the truth.
Yeah, that's right.
That's all. I like a little bit true. Mm-hmm. I
like it. That's all you got to do.
I say, and release that stress, that shock. Mm-hmm. I'm feeling good now.
Indigo is breathing in.
I'm about to go do my show anyway. Ready to tune in. Okay.
All right. What time is the show?
Soon as I leave here, give me about 10, 15 minutes.
All right. About 10 to 15. We're going to be tuning in.
I'm trying to tell you. 9:15 it is. Okay. I'm going to have to befriend you and share you, my brother. Yeah. Keep doing what you're doing. You are necessary. Definitely. You are necessary. I'm going to have to give me a king hat, too. I'm about to walk around with one, too.
I'll be giving me a hoodie.
Let them know that you know who you is.
Right.
I might as well walk it. That's why I got my mic. I'm rocking the chain too, man. This right here is eternal life. People don't understand what this means.
It's called the unk,
correct. And female, this is the womb right here. This is the fallopian tubes, and this is the birth canal. Mm-hmm. And male, this is the prostate. These are the testicles, and these are the staff. People don't understand what this means.
Hey, you better educate, brother.
Symbols are everything.
That's right.
Symbols are everything. Without doubt, man. Make sure you check out my man Indigo. What's your Facebook again, bro?
Just type in my government name, Spencer Williams, SpencerWillams /Indigo Kid.
And we can catch your show at 9:15 today.
9:15 is going
okay.
down.
All right.
I'm gonna get it on right now.
All right.
Thank y'all so much for having me.
Thank you.
No problem. Thanks for the young sister inviting you. Because we like to brag up our neighbors. Of course, you got a skill set, you open your third eye.
Right.
And then hopefully, like the sister before us, you can open up a school to teach other people how to open up their third eye.
Online academies are always a good thing.
Online academies?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, without a doubt. Mm-hmm.
Oh, skirt sets and everything.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, without a doubt.
Look, we brainstorming up here. Another stream of income.
Another stream of income. Indigo Kid.
Oh,
yes.
My God. Don't be afraid to share the information.
That's
man.
Right.
Please,
that's
I didn't right. learn nothing today. Share the information. Yeah. I appreciate 95.7 the most. Without a doubt, we appreciate you. We're going to reciprocate. Oh, yeah. We got three crowns.
Make sure y'all win.
You got to know who you are.
You gotta know who you are.
Omaha, Nebraska, boss with us.
Boss with us.
Said you looking for a rapper. Well, baby, I'm a rock star. Said you looking for a trapper. Well, maybe I'm a blaster. Yeah,
I got what you need. All you need is let me turn you up now. I promise the time of your life whenever we get out now. Hey, Maybe this a rock-a-bye, baby come.
And then I stuck it in the mailbox. Real thick like Latifah. Her girl got a girl like Monifa. I'm on fire, man, I spit ether. Yeah, they want me like the Drake feature. Let me leak that. So sweet like a Fanta. Real juicy Tropicana. Put it in her mouth, that banana. She want a thug in the life. Said them blanks ain't in the ride. Hey, she call me over. I came through and gave her that.
Said you looking for a rapper. Well, baby, I'm a rock star. Said you looking for a trapper. Well, baby, I'm a blaster. Yeah.
I got what you need. All you need is let me turn you on now. I promise the time of your life whenever we get out now. Hey.
Baby, this a lullaby. Baby, this a rock-a-bye. Baby, come. Baby, this a lullaby, baby, this a rock-a-bye, baby, come. Baby, this a lullaby, baby, this a rock-a-bye, baby, come.
baby, this a lullaby. Baby, this a rockabye.
Baby, girl. Baby, come on over here and get it. Feel it. Roll with it. It was softer than some linen last night. It was right. We in tune. Satellite. Out of sight. Out of mind. I should feed it for the people like a stomach. I clean it out and flush it. Do it like a loop video. Go. Go ahead and bust it for your daddy. Let me get back to the money like I'm Weezy. I ain't never gonna be the one that's gonna take it easy. I'ma get up in the kitty like a checkup from the clinic when I'm in it. You gon' think it was a never in a sitting high. Make you feel the life of a trapper. Yeah, that snapper got me seen it for no reason. I pick it up and eat it like I mean it. I don't mean it, that's the way I am. And I ain't never acting. I'm a captain. I'm so certified to make you feel the action like a blessing. You got values, true values. Giselle and Chanel can't even I stand you.
Well, baby, I'm a rock star. Said you looking for a trapper. Well, baby, I'm a blaster. Yeah,
I got what you need. All you need is let me turn you on. Now, I promise the time of your life whenever we get out. Now, hey,
baby, this a lullaby. Baby, this a rockabye. Baby, girl. Baby, this a lullaby. Baby, this a rockabye, baby girl. Baby, this a lullaby. Baby, this a rockabye, baby girl. Baby, this a lullaby. Baby, this a rockabye, baby girl.
Call me straight, I'm getting bent. I beat the beat down, beat the beat down, beat the